at this time in 1990, my final two or three students finished their PhD. And so that gave me a grand total of 28 students. Mathematicians say that 28 is a perfect number. It's just a bit of a joke, but if you consider all the divisors of 28, it's 14, 7, 4, 2, and 1, and that adds up to 28, so it's called a perfect number. Remarkable 28 students, 28 different personalities, from many different parts of the world. About half of them went into academic careers, and half of them are in industry. For example, the people who worked with me on TeX, Michael Plass became one of the key programmers for Xerox in their DocuTech systems and many of their desktop publishing system. Frank Liang went on to be one of the key people in Microsoft Word. Many of the students that I had in the typography program, again, were very have leadership roles in the software industry for printing. Bob Sedgewick was chair of the Princeton Computer Science Department. Jeff Vitter, chair of the Purdue Computer Science Department, now dean there. And so on. I have a lot of academic students. Others are back in their native countries in Spain, Brazil. So all in all, I really grateful that I had so many great students who pretty much taught me as much as I taught them. Well, I like to take credit for their successes. It's really there. They were great and are great. Only one of my students was a sad case, and he seems to have committed suicide after an unhappy life. One out of 28, I think, it's a pretty good scorecard. I still see at least half of them because they're in this area now. Reminds me, I might as well mention a huge surprise on my 64th birthday when people came from all over the world for a two-day celebration, and Jill had kept it totally secret from me. And I just couldn't believe every time I look another way, I'd see yet another amazing person who came. Why 64 years birthday? Well, to a computer scientist, the number 64 is, the powers of two are the most important numbers. So after 32, then the next interesting number is 64. And after that, 128 is the next interesting number. So I doubt if I'll have another more appropriate birthday time. And so we call it my millionth birthday, since in the binary number system, you write 64 as 1 followed by 60. And that's when I got to see lots and lots of my students. So I thought came up now.